I will be back in a few minutes. All right, folks. We've been back less than 24 hours and I've made my first sale since I've been back. So I'm off to sell a guitar that I had listed. It's the first guitar sale I've had. I'd love to get into more guitar sales. I love music. Music's my thing. But I'm off to make this sale. It sold the Epiphone Dot. And then it is business as usual starting this week because I need to get the shipping container done and then start getting some sales because we're coming up on July and then I want to get some money coming in so I can do a little bit more business action. So I'll check you guys out in a little bit. All right, so we are here. I just want to check, make sure that I get everything in here. I probably should have done this before I left the house, but whatever. So let's just see how. All right, so it is all in there. Epiphone Dot. Check the innards. There is nothing hidden in there. All right, so let's go make this deal. All right, the deal is done. Now I'm off to do a little errands and stuff, but really cool guys that I sold the guitar to. They play in a band, play on like a Armed Forces tour. It's just, so it's really good. That Epiphone Dot will go on and play with some people and actually just not set the case. So very cool on that, very cool people. I love reselling because you never know who you're going to meet or the story behind, you know, why they're buying what they're doing or why they're selling what they're doing. So very cool. So I told them guys, if they ever played out, I'd definitely come see them. Very cool, very nice guys. So it's gone to a good home and now I'm off to hit the shipping container. Folks, I am, as you can see, at the shipping container. I'm getting ready to lock up. Came over here to pick up the mower so I can do a little domestic activity because I was gone for a week. This week, though, is I am going to jump on this thing and I'm going to attack it and I'm going to get it done because I need to get all my stuff moved in here because start of July, I need to be selling so I can make some stuff happen. Because it'll be the busy part of our year and I want to get some things listed, sold, and make that money because I want to either buy another shipping container or another building by the end of the year. Don't know whether I'll make that or not, but you got to have goals so you can try to make things shake and bake. So here's a little video that I recorded prior to leaving that goes over how we took the shipping container, put it up on blocks, and then got the well installed. So hope you enjoy.
put this in the middle, roughly the middle, because it weighs some and the string will sag in the middle. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to put it over here because it's going to throw your level off. So you want to be approximately in the middle. You about nailed it.
Looking good.
All right, we are got everything leveled out there. We use the line level?
Yes, technically we don't have anything leveled. We just have a string line that's level. And now we got to determine how deep we need to put our forms for these little footings.
This is a nice contrast between me kind of getting it right and it actually being right, which is why I have Jeremy here, by the way.
Maybe. So this is a great opportunity for to say,
yeah,
because you have these elevations on if you can get this.
Yeah. We're going in.
So, you know, our string line is this dimension from the ground level off in each corner. So that means that in the back, we need to go deeper than we do in the front.
Yep.
In order to get it level. So we just have to look at the difference between all these numbers. We'll pick the lowest one and we'll work off of that.
What's the rough depth of the drums right now?
12 inches.
12 inches, okay.
Yeah. They're about 12 inches. So I think if it was me, I'd stick them out 4 inches.
Out of the ground?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And put 8 inches in. So that, but we have to take into consideration that there's gonna be, you know, a maximum of 4 inches different.
Mm-hmm.
So that means that the one in the back, just talk through this, the one in the back is going to be down 8 inches and the one in the front is only going to be down 4 inches.
Yep.
You know, if we want 4 inches.
Yeah. No, so, I think 4 inches is good.
Yeah.
That's a good
to thing. Stick out.
Yep.
Yeah. So the one in the front is going to be sticking out 8 inches, 4 inches in the ground. And if that's a problem, then we can make taller ones in certain circumstances.
Yes. We'll take the other drums, maybe one of the drums that we haven't cut, and make one bigger.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anyway, we'll figure it out.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, and we will continue on. We are at the last one, so here we go. All right, last pour here. Last pour, folks. All right, good news today, because today not only are we gonna get the concrete slabs in, also gonna get the well installed in the back there, so that's good news. Been waiting probably about 3 or 4 months for that to happen, getting all the permits, all that stuff ready to roll. The guys are gonna show up this afternoon, so I'll get to show you what it's like installing a well. Cool.
Hey, putting in that tub down there?
Yeah.
That tub, and we're recycling the water with the pump in there, sucking it out, going up down into that. Now we're drilling it out, flushing it out. At the bottom and it starts drinking. We see good material. Well, you can see that white thing in there, the feedback, the black thing in here. It fits inside the pipe. So it pushes our string down to where we want it, holds it in place. Whatever our problem is, we can pull it out.
So when the guy comes back on Monday, is he putting like another similar pipe down?
We're going to put a 30-foot straw down inside the well.
Okay.
It's going to come up an hour and open it up.
Okay.
Pick it up out of the tray, remove it, pick it up down the water.
So if I hook up an electric pump, do I go in parallel with that one or take that one off? Alright, here we go, folks.
It's going to be inch and a quarter, so this is the checkout. It's going to be sticking out like that, so all you got to do is glue to it.
Okay.
It'll be sticking out the bottom. You pick it up like this, and it'll pick up water and shoot water like a straw. You know, you put your finger over it,
yeah.
Pick it up and down. That's how it's going to be, but it's going to be a 30-foot straw inside the well. And then it's going to have one like this, but it'll be inch and a quarter. And what it's going to be, it's going to be reamed out, beat over the pipe, so it sits inside a feed mill. It'll be sitting inside one of these like that, but not glued. You don't need to glue it. It's called a vintage drop pipe. This is a K-packer. This is what holds the screen in place.
Yeah.
this to the PVC on the top of it, so it comes in through here, up through the middle of the pipe, up to the pump.
Cool, so that's slitted and then it comes in through there?
It's called a screen. They've got three different sizes and it depends on what's in the ground.
Okay.
It's going to be like one like this. This is going to be screwed onto the casing. This ain't going to be in there. This is going to be sitting in there with a pipe going down through the middle of it.
Yep.
It's just going to sit in there. You can wiggle back and forth. It's going to pop up.
All right.
And you can juke it up and down. The check valve's going to be out here, so you can juke it up and down and then hook to this side.
Okay.
So you're probably going to want to put a quick disconnect or something so you can put your pump inside.
Okay. Cool.
If you have any questions while I'm doing it, I can show you Monday.
All right.
If you do a little better, I'll have more parts, and I'll be able to show you exactly how it works.
Sounds good.
Okay. We're going to pump water. We'll drink it before we leave. I guess you can drink it.
Okay.
Not going to hurt you. We're going to try to get you at least 25 gallons. Okay. I don't know exactly what you're using it for.
Irrigation, and then maybe like, you know, what we saw.
It should be about 35 gallons, but we guarantee 25.
Cool. So this is like a smaller family business, or is it pretty big?
My boss has been doing this a long time. His stepdad, pretty much, I took over, and he's retired.
Yeah. Cool.
So like 4 months behind.
Man. Well, you got good business, man.
Yeah. Definitely good. Well grown to dying breed.
Yeah.
There ain't a lot of us around here anymore.
Cool. So. Yep.
When they go in and that water level goes down, that's when you take water. The ground's taking the water. When the ground takes the water, it makes the water.
Okay.
That's when they decide what they're going to use. They're going to put that clay in that bucket in there, hold the hole open, put the screen in there, then we're going to pump it.
Cool.
It'll get real nasty, and then it'll get crystal clean. We'll drink it, test it, and when you're happy, we're happy to know.
Cool. Sounds good.
And you said, when do you pay?
What's that?
When do you want to pay?
I can pay today or Monday.
Well, I'm saying Monday. You said you're going to be cash?
Yeah.
So Monday, when I come to the drop by, I'll call you.
Okay.
So you can meet up with me, and I'll show you how it all works, and maybe I'll give you a receipt.
Cool. Sounds great. All right. Should have a well start today. We'll finish it up Monday. Well, all right, it is a big day here, folks, because we're getting ready to use a crane to move the shipping container onto those concrete pads that we poured. So it should be a pretty easy move for these guys, just but we'll see. I got to haul butt, get there, get all the stuff out of the shipping container before these guys show up. I've only got a matter of minutes. Am I going to get it done? Am I not going to get it done? Who knows? But it'll get moved, I guarantee that. I'm trying to get everything wrapped up on this part of it because at the end of the next week, I am going to go to the big KY to see the family, go pick up some auto parts, go hit some sourcing things, and do some cool stuff. So I'll let you guys see how the move goes. right, container is now on the pads. Everything's looking good over there. Next step is to finish installing the well here in the back, which will be going down this afternoon. So, successful day. Now I'm off to go tackle some other projects, and then I'll let you know when the well guy shows up. All right, shallow well has been installed. Always have a hard time doing that. I don't know how weather people do it. It's a lot harder than what you think. We have a front coming in. Anyway, he installed the drop pipe, and then the check valve in here was not as dramatic as what I thought. I thought maybe like a ribbon cutting or something like that. I don't know what I was thinking. But anyway, this is what you get when they're done with a shallow well. See if I can reproduce and do the same thing he did. So we will install our pump on this side. It'll probably be a disconnect, and then I'll take it off, put it back on. I want to make sure nobody runs into this, so I'll probably have to put some something out in front of it. But see if I can reproduce what he did, which apparently I cannot. Oh, hold on a second. All right, take two has started. I'm getting ready to show you. If you never noticed, I do a lot of take twos in my videos. I have a lot of take twos in my life. I am a continuous screw up. 40 years actually of screwing up, so no big deal on this side of the camera. So let's check it out and see how the well turned out. So we've got the pipe going down. That's a galvanized pipe going all the way down to the ground. It goes down about 65 feet in this location, comes up, hits a 90, then you get a check valve installed. All this is kind of done inside the pipe. You can see the outside diameter versus this tube that goes down into it, and literally I can start pumping water. So very cool there. I'm going to probably be doing this for about 30 minutes. The guy said that I'll get brown water coming out in the beginning because they put either some sand or some clay in the bottom of it, the well, to make sure it doesn't close in until they get the vent pipe in there. So we're good to go on it. So you also noticed that we got the shipping container put on the pads. Good job. Things turned out great there. There were a couple of things that I wish we'd have done a little bit different, but I might just leave it as is. Let me show you what I'm talking about here. So you can see that the corner of the shipping container is a little bit further in and to the side, more. I'd like to have this a little bit further out this way. What we did was, is what I probably should have done a little different was, is instead of taking the dimensions from the corner, I should have went from the center point of the mounting. So that way I got a little bit more dimension, or a little bit better dimensions, because I'm a little bit further, too far out and to the side on these things. But it could probably work. A couple other things that I'm gonna have to work out here is the door. I'm gonna have to jimmy with it a little bit. It's a little bit out of kilter, but we'll get that all straightened out. But overall, I'm pretty excited. Containers on pads, everything looks good. I walked it on the inside. Everything, you know, feels pretty level. So very good. So we're going to keep on trucking on this project, get the inside done. Hopefully next week we get the permit so we can get power and then water, and power back to the water so we can get that all set up. And then I'm going to keep on trucking on the container. I'm going to get the walls put up, get the electric ran, and get everything ready to roll on it so I can actually move on to some other projects, because I need to make some money, because all this stuff costs money to actually do. So now it's trying to replenish the coffers. So thanks for watching, and there'll probably be a little gap in my videos here because next week I'm going to KY. All right, let's see how we did here. It's kind of weird because it echoes into this. All right, so let's check it out and let's see how we did on the bubble. Whoa, that looks pretty dang good. So an excellent leveling job done by Mechanical Intimidator. So let's check out the inside. And here we are in the middle. Let's see how we did. Looks pretty dang good. Excellent work. All right, now let's check it from the backside here and see how we did. I think it's pretty dang good. Look at that, folks. Look at that. We are right in the middle of the bubble. Boom! Way to go, Jeremy. You knocked it out of the park. Awesome. We'll be right back.
Keep on singing.